Hello? Come in. Sit. Christ, man, it's all about ego. This whole town runs on ego.
Yeah, I'm Bobby.
Bonnie, come in here, can you? Bonnie, this is my nephew, Bobby.
What was it about this role as Bonnie that appealed to you?
So I auditioned for this part before I read the script. And I had a conversation on the phone with Woody. And he described the part as being a very buoyant, light, lovely young lady. And that he knows that I'm a good actress, but that he's never seen me do that. And so I had to prove myself a little bit. So I went in and I read a scene that I had never read before, and I didn't read a script or anything, and I thought that there was no chance in hell that I was gonna get the part. And then ultimately it worked out, and I read the script, and it's a perfectly written script. His language and his rhythm, it's all in there, and the fact that it takes place in the late 30s, that's a really forward story to tell. Mm-hmm. That's a very unconventional story to tell and modern. And so I thought the girl was really cool.
I don't think that's a very good idea, actually.
No?
I'm seeing someone.
Oh, what's he like?
Doug is a journalist.
Oh, I just thought since you had so much free time on your hands.
He travels a lot. And I really like spending my time with you. I hope that's okay. You know, you're very sweet. Have you heard that before? You have this deer in the headlights quality.
Within that era, it was not respectable to not have your life figured out at a young age with a man. And she makes odd choices, and she's spontaneous, and she's impulsive. Even though life becomes a little overwhelming sometimes, there's never the sense of shame. There's an ambiguity to the way she approaches life that is so modern, that's so of our time and not then.
Yeah.
So I was like, that's a really cool story to tell. She really trusts her gut, and there's a clarity that she just has, even though things are very confusing, life is like, you never really have the answers. There is a soulful clarity that's very attractive about her. And if that wasn't there, the story wouldn't work. Just because you can't label something or call it by a name, he's not my husband, he's not my boyfriend, he's not my friend, therefore, does it exist? It's like, yeah, absolutely. It's just kind of different.
Are there more beautiful girls in Hollywood or New York?
Why, is that how you'll decide where you'll live?
You're very beautiful.
I'm seeing someone.
Oh.
Unrequited love kills more people in any year than tuberculosis.
Don't you want to try me?
Listen, I'm so lonely, I would have been happy just to talk, but now I'm even too tired for that.
You like jazz music?
At 2 in the morning.
At any time in the morning.
Love is not rational. You fall in love. You lose control.
Ooh. Whoa. Is that good or bad?
What's it like to work with Woody Allen?
He gives a lot more freedom than I ever expected.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, his movies sound like, you know, you hear a band and you know the band well. Even if you don't know a particular song, you're like, oh, I know that band, isn't that? And his movies are like that. I mean, they're him.
Mm-hmm.
And so I thought that there would be more, I don't know, like more control. Like there would be more, but that tone is really intrinsic. It just happens. And like I think all the moments that really wound up being the moments that hit hard are the ones in between scripted moments. And I think that he knows that that's gonna happen. He's absolutely responsible for that and like the catalyst for it. Yeah, he's a trip. He's really honest, he's really funny. He doesn't talk on set a whole lot. He really kind of gives the part to the actors.
Yes?